Dear Vine, hi, my name is Colin Andrews and I am an aspiring film critic, filmmaker, and video essayist. First of all, I know that this is pretty weird that you're an inanimate object and not a specific person, just an entity, but bear with me, I'm going to try this out and see how it goes. Well, how do I begin? Originally, I didn't even find you. I was actually introduced to you in the year 2013 by my best friend at the time. He tried to show me you and some of his favorite creators on you, and I was honestly kind of out of it. He was talking about you as if all you had was physical comedy videos where that was the whole joke, and as someone who thought that they were superior to everyone else as a senior in high school, I simply wasn't having it. I know, I look back at myself at that time and cannot stop myself from cringing. But as most seniors in high school can attest to, I didn't really have anything to do most of the time, apart from a part-time job and my senior project. So when my best friend created a Vine account and asked me to start being in them and working on them with him, I thought it could be a pretty interesting venture. The next 6 months sent the two of us down a spiral of literally making at least 3 Vines every single week, and I can't tell you how much fun we had with your platform. This was back in a time where I didn't have any interest in making a living off of social media, so we were just doing it for fun. And it was the most pure and amazing interaction with the internet I've ever had. We didn't garner any more than a couple hundred followers, but it didn't even matter, as we didn't have any time to look at the stats because we were too busy planning out what we would do for the next day as a Vine. Every day after we came back from our 2 different schools, we would meet up at my place, drop the videos for the day, and then go out into the world and make them. We lived right next to a park, a movie theater, and a strip mall. It was as if we had the whole world at our feet. Although I enjoyed my senior year for many other reasons that would take too long to get into for this letter, you were the main reason I have so many amazing memories from it. Eventually, you were shut down in 2016, and along with you, all of our mini masterpieces were no more, as my friend felt embarrassed if they were to be unearthed by someone else. And while I may have understood his sentiment, I wish he hadn't have done that. I have never been a big social media guy, and even to this day, the only personal account I have is my Instagram. So, for this allotted amount of time in my youth, the only recorded memories that I have are on an account that doesn't exist anymore. And something that I initially scoffed at was, surprisingly, where I got my start with putting creative content on social media. There is a case to be made that I wouldn't be making this video now if I hadn't posted a bunch of dumb stuff on you as a stupid 17-year-old who was still attempting to find his creative voice. The videos may have just been the two of us doing dumb sketches revolving around puns in various different places, but they were authentic and ours. And the memories that I will have from those absolutely blissful 6 months will never fade away. I promise that I won't let them. Now, I know that this sounds like this is where the letter should end, but we still have another part to the story. After that stint in high school, you never really came back into my mind until 2017. The thing is that, even though I was constantly making content to post on you, I never actually watched a single video you had to offer. As I said previously, I didn't really utilize social media, and the account we posted videos to was on my friend's phone, so I never even had my own Vine account. So anyways, flash forward to 2017. I'm living alone in a pretty tiny one-bedroom apartment on my campus, and I am as depressed and in a rut as I think I have ever been. However, I was lucky enough to have someone who is just as depressed as I was, one of my best friends at the current moment, Trent. We would often spend most of that year in my apartment eating Taco Bell, playing random games, and Fortnite on my Xbox One. That's how you know we were depressed. Or doing the most depressing thing of all, going to Denny's at 3 in the morning. One day we were watching a bunch of JonTron videos on my couch and something showed up in my recommended section. It was a Vine compilation. Trent, as a seasoned veteran of the Vine culture that I had no idea existed, decided to click on it, and I was immediately hooked. I saw all of the classics in succinct succession, and I was just in awe, partially because of how funny I found them, and partially because they reminded me of the content I was making back when I was 17. After I got over the initial thought that we could have made it big on Vine if we had just kept pushing it, I had to have more. For almost an entire 24 hours, when both of us had classes we needed to be getting to, Trent and I sat in my apartment together and watched countless amounts of Vine compilations covering what seemed to be every single sector that you had to offer. This was how I figured out some creators that I loved got their start from you. Cody Coe, Danny Gonzalez, Zaynen Heath, Christine Sidelko, Evan Breen, Nick Coletti, Casey Frey, Josh Ovaye, Meech on Mars, and Dope Island all had individual compilations dedicated to them. It was like unlocking some bonus content that I had never seen before, and by the end of the next day, I had kind of lost my voice from laughing. And the funny thing about it is, for the first time in that whole year at university, I hadn't felt down in the dumps for a whole 24 hours. There were no negative thoughts creeping in and infiltrating my mind as they so commonly did. There was only free shivakadu and gluten-free Papa John's pizza and a little bit of Fortnite and hours of Vines. To this day, I don't know if that has ever been topped in terms of absolute relief felt throughout my body and my existence. Eventually, Trent had to leave, but I kept watching them until I had to leave for my 9 a.m. the following morning. From that moment on until I moved out of that dinky apartment, it was a tradition that whenever Trent would come over, which was generally a couple times every week, we would find at least one new compilation to watch together. So, and I know this sounds corny, but you know those compilations out there of you that say Vines that cured my depression? Well, in my case, you actually kind of did. Not cured necessarily, as I was still very depressed until the abysmal school year was over, but you provided a reprieve for me to push all of that self-hatred and doubt to the side for a rather brief moment to reminisce on my time of innocence and think that maybe, just maybe, there was a chance that I could return to the place again. And I did. Look at me now. Over 2,000 subscribers on YouTube, and there's a very high chance that none of this would have been possible if it wasn't for you. You meant so much to me. You still mean so much to me, and I don't think I can ever repay you for how much you truly helped me. Whether it is for dragging me out of the metaphorical grave that I dug myself, or helping me relish my youth in a scrapbook that will never be seen by human eyes. Again, thank you. Sincerely, Colin Andrews.